This is the second lecture of the epithelium. The lecture will discuss about the pseudostratified ciliated columnar epithelium and the types of the stratified epithelium, that is the stratified squamous, the stratified cuboidal, the stratified columnar, and the special type of the epithelium, that is the transitional epithelium. The pseudostratified ciliated columnar epithelium, it is located in the trachea, bronchi, and the large excretory ducts of the glands, the portions of the male urethra, epididymis, and also the some of the portion of the tympanic cavity. The pseudostratified ciliated columnar epithelium consists of a single layer of the cells, but all the cells, they rest on the basement membrane, but they do not reach the apical surface. And the level of the nuclei is at the different levels, so it gives a false appearance of being stratified. So pseudostratified is actually a false appearance of this being stratified, but it is actually a single layer. So the cells, they are of the different types, that are the tall columnar cells, the short basal cells, and also there are few of the goblet cells in between these cells. So they all rest on the basement membrane, but they do not reach the apical surface. This type of the epithelium is also called the respiratory epithelium, as it lines the nasal cavity and the respiratory tract, the trachea, the bronchi. So it is also called the respiratory epithelium. So the surface has the modifications like the cilia and the sterocilia. The goblet cells, they secrete the mucus, and the cilia, they help to spread the mucus over the surface. So functions is basically the secretion, particularly of the mucus, and the propulsion of the mucus by the ciliary action. So this is a diagrammatic representation of the pseudostratified epithelium. You can see the short basal cells, these are the tall columnar ciliated cells. So it is showing you the lining of the respiratory tract. Now the stratified epithelia. So as stratified epithelium consists of two or more layers of the cells, and the epithelium, it regenerates from the basal layer. Its major role is the protection. The name or the nomenclature of the stratified epithelia is according to the shape of the apical surface layer. So if the apical layer is the consists of the squamous cells, then we call it a stratified squamous epithelium. And if the surface cells is of the cuboidal shaped cells, then we call it a stratified cuboidal epithelium. Or if the surface layer is of the columnar shaped cells, then we call it a stratified columnar epithelium. So we'll discuss the each type of the epithelia one by one. The stratified squamous epithelium is of two types, keratinized or the non-keratinized epithelium. So over the surface, if there is a layer of the keratinization, then it is called the stratified keratinized epithelium layer, and it is has a protective function. And if it is does not have the keratinized layer, then we call it a non-keratinized epithelium. So this non-keratinized type of the stratified epithelium forms the moist lining of the body openings. So this is the stratified squamous epithelium, and it has a thick membrane which is composed of the several layers. The basal layers, they are the cuboidal layer of the cells, and they are metabolically active. And then there are these various layers of the polyhedral cells, and the surface layer is may be keratinized or the non-keratinized, and the surface cells is full of the so its protection function is to protect the underlying tissues and the area subjected to the abrasions. Now, the non-keratinized type of the stratified epithelium, it lines the oral cavity, the oesophagus, and the vagina. Whereas the keratinized variety, it forms the epidermis of the skin or a dry membrane. The keratinized type of the epithelium or stratified, it also lines the hard palate also, and also the papilla of the tongue. The stratified cuboidal epithelium. So as we have discussed, the stratified epithelia consist of two or more layers, and the name of the epithelia is according to the surface layer. So the surface layer is also the cuboidal epithelium, so therefore we call it a stratified cuboidal epithelium. So stratified cuboidal epithelium, it lines the ducts of the sweat glands. Main function is the protection, also secretion, and also the absorption. So you can here see the stratified cuboidal epithelium. The basal layer is also the cuboidal epithelium, and it consists of two layers, and the surface layer is also the cuboidal epithelium. So this is the duct of the sweat gland showing you the stratified cuboidal epithelium. Now the stratified columnar epithelium, it's a rare type of the epithelium and composed of the column-shaped cells arranged in multiple layers. It is found in the conjunctiva, pharynx, and the male urethra. So the basal layer consists of the cuboidal to columnar layer, and the surface layer is the columnar layer. So therefore, we call it a stratified columnar epithelium. So this is the photomicrograph of the stratified columnar epithelium, and you can see the layer of the surface layer, the column-like layer, and the basal layer is the cuboidal epithelium. Transitional epithelium or the urothelium, it is restricted to the passages of the renal passages from the minor calyx up to the urethra. It is a type of the stratified epithelium, but it does not named according to the surface layer. Its appearance varies considerably depending upon the degree of the distension to which it is subjected. The superficial layer in the of the cells in the non-distending organ appears rounded or dome-shaped and often show a free convex border that bulges into the lumen. The superficial cells may vary in shape from the squamous to the cuboidal epithelium depending upon their subjected to distension. So this is a diagram showing you of the urinary bladder, and in this you can see in the distended state, that is the full bladder. So a full bladder which is distended, the surface layer of the dome-shaped cells, they appear squamous and they are stretched and distended. Whereas in the undistended state or an empty bladder, you can see the several layers of the epithelium and the surface of the dome-shaped cells which are distended into the lumen. So this is a relaxed bladder or a contracted bladder, and this is a full bladder or a stretched bladder. So in this state we have two to three layers, and the surface layer appears squamous. Therefore it is called the transitional epithelium, that its shape is transitional between the surface of the. Now you can see here this photomicrograph. The clearly the dome-shaped cells, they are visible, and these dome-shaped cells, they are have the two or more nuclei. You can see that two nuclei in this layer, and the pear-shaped cells in between these surface dome-shaped cells. And then we have the polyhedral cells, 2 to 3 layers of the polyhedral cells, and the basal layer is the cuboidal epithelium. Now this is also the diagrammatic representation of the transitional epithelium, showing you the basal layer of the cuboidal epithelium, the polyhedral cells, 2 to 3 layers of the polyhedral cells, and these are the pear-shaped cells in which the surface dome-shaped cells, they are fit into the these openings of these pear-shaped cells. Now this surface dome-shaped cells, they are joined together by the tight junctions, and they have also a glycocalyx coating over the surface. So this stretches readily and permits the distension of the urinary organ, and they are contained urine, therefore they have the tight junctions in between them. This is another photomicrograph of this transitional epithelium. So clearly you can appreciate all the layers of the epithelium, from the surface layer to the basal layer. Okay, thank you. This is